Assalamu alaikum everyone. Hope you all are doing well. Let's discuss about our weekly homework. This is your maths class and I'm your maths teacher. Now take out your maths countdown book 2. So as you can see, these are the learning objectives on which you have to practice in this class. Multiplication, converting ones, converting tens. Commutative property, times table. First of all, let's take a start from multiplication. Multiplication is a mathematical method in which multiply means the number of things increase in the group. As you can see here, the sum is given in 100 tens ones column. Let's see how it can be multiplied. Look at the sum. First, multiply the ones column with the multiplier, that is 2. 2 multiplied by 3 is equal to 6. Then, next, multiply the tens column with the multiplier, like 6 multiplied by 3 is equal to 18. So, it means there are too many tens. So, convert 1. Convert tens into 100 and shift 1 from 18 on hundreds column. After that, multiply the 100 columns with the multiplier that 2 multiplied by 3 is equal to 6. Now remember to add the shifted one on 100 column from tens. So now 2 multiplied by 3 is equal to 6 and 6 plus 1 is equal to be 7. And the answer 786. So students, now open page numbers 74 and do exercise 1 in book. Complete all the parts by applying a multiplication method and also converting tens and one. Now turn on page number 75 and do exercise 2. Complete all the parts in book by converting tens okay, and another exercise on this page, exercise 3. Exercise 3, now complete this. It may be necessary to convert both tens and ones. When you multiply 3 by a multiplier 6, the answer comes out to be 1818. Okay, now shift 1. Now shift the 1 on tens column, then multiply 4 by multiplier 4 by a 6. The answer came out to be 6 multiplied by 4 is equal to 24. Also add the shifted 1 and on tens column, so it become 25. Now transfer or shift the 2 on 100 column. Okay, and multiply 1 by a multiplier 6. So the answer came out, yes, 6, but also add the shifted 2 on 100 columns. Now it will be written as 8 and the answer 858. Now something is done in another given 2 example. You can see here. Always remember, never write 2 digits in 1 column. If after multiplying the answer came in 2 digits, shift it on another column and add it by converting ones and tens. Okay? So now we will learn about commutative property. Here you have to understand, when multiplying 2 numbers, the numbers you can put in any orders and the answer will remain same. It say Whenever pattern you choose to multiply the answer of two digits, the answer of two digits came out to be same. For example, as you can see there, these are some dots. Okay, these having three rows, 1, 2, 3, three rows, and 1, 2, 3, and 5 columns. How many columns? 5 columns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 columns. So you can write 5 multiplied by 3, and that is equal to 1, 5, 15. And now on another hand, there are 5 rows. Look here. There are 5 rows and 3 columns. So you can also write like 3 multiplied by 5, and the answer will be remain same, that is 1, 5, 15. Okay, now open page number 76 and complete all the parts in book. These are the sums of commutative property. Always remember, the answer will remain same when you do the sums of commutative property. Like when you multiply 5 by 10, the answer will be 15, and when you multiply 10 by 5, the answer will be same again, 15. Now turn on page number 77 and complete exercise 1 by remembering the timetables. Complete all the parts. Like when you multiply 4 by a multiplier 3, the answer came out to be 12. Okay, now shift the 1 on which column? Yes, another column, 10th column, and add it. After multiplying 1 by a multiplier 3, the answer will be 3. Then add 1, so you can write like 4. 4 to 42. Now something is done in another example. Multiply 1, 3, 13 by a table of 2. Like 3 multiply by multiply 2, the answer will be 6. And by multiplying 1 from a multiplier 2, the answer will be 2. So you can write like 26. Now complete all the following parts in book. Multiplication is a simple and quick method, but you must know the tables to solve the multiplication sums. That's all for now. Let's wind up our weekly homework. Hope you understand the concept of multiplication very well. Keep practicing all the sums. Okay, take care. Allah Hafiz.